Salyut 1, the world's first space station. Launched by the Soviet Union in 1971, Salyut 1 was a monolithic outpost sent up in a single piece. Its first crewed mission, Soyuz 10, failed to dock successfully. The second mission, Soyuz 11, was a triumph, with the three-man crew inhabiting the station for a record-breaking 23 days, proving humans could live and work in space for extended periods. The mission ended in tragedy, however, when the Soyuz 11 crew perished during their return to Earth due to a capsule depressurization. Skylab, America's first and only solo space station. In a brilliant act of recycling, Skylab was built from a converted upper stage of a Saturn V rocket. Launched in 1973, it was damaged during ascent, losing one solar array and its micrometeoroid shield, which also served as a thermal shield. The first crew had to perform a daring spacewalk to repair the station, a testament to human ingenuity. Its massive interior volume allowed for groundbreaking medical experiments on long-duration spaceflight, and it served as a powerful solar observatory. It hosted three crews before its orbit decayed, and it burned up over Australia in 1979. Salyut Program. This was the successful follow-on program that established the Soviet Union as the master of long-duration spaceflight. The series was split into two types: civilian scientific stations and top-secret military reconnaissance stations, which were disguised with Salyut designations. These stations, though plagued by early failures, allowed cosmonauts to progressively break human endurance records, master cargo resupply missions, and learn how to conduct complex work in orbit, paving the direct path to Mir. Mir, the first modular space station and the crowning achievement of the Soviet space program. Launched in 1986, Mir began as a single core module. Over the next decade, five more science modules were added, creating a large, complex orbital outpost. It held the record for the longest continuous human presence in space for 10 years, surviving fires, collisions, and the collapse of the Soviet Union itself. The Shuttle Mir program saw American astronauts become long-term residents, marking a new era of cooperation before the station was deorbited in 2001. ISS, the largest and most complex machine ever built in space, a joint project between the United States, Russia, Europe, Japan, and Canada. The ISS is the pinnacle of international cooperation in science and engineering. Assembly began in 1998, and it has been continuously inhabited by a multinational crew since November 2000. The size of a football field, this orbiting laboratory is dedicated to scientific research in a microgravity environment, testing technologies for future deep space missions and serving as a symbol of peaceful collaboration. Tiangong-1 and Tiangong-2, China's prototype space stations. These were not permanent outposts, but smaller, single-module, heavenly palaces designed as testbeds. Their primary mission was to allow China to master the critical technologies needed for a large space station, including rendezvous, automated docking, and life support systems. Visited by several Shenzhou crews, including China's first female taikonauts, these two precursor labs were the essential stepping stones that successfully demonstrated China's capability to build and operate its own space station. Tiangong Space Station, China's modern, permanent, and modular space station. Construction began in 2021, and the station is a T-shaped design similar in concept to Mir, consisting of a core module and two laboratory modules. The successful completion of the Tiangong station makes China only the third country in history to independently build and operate a long-term human outpost in orbit. It now serves as the primary platform for Chinese national science experiments and is open to international collaboration on China's terms. Future stations. The next generation of space stations will be fundamentally different. The Lunar Gateway will not be in low Earth orbit, but in orbit around the Moon. It is a small, minimalist outpost designed to serve as a staging point for the Artemis missions, a command center and waypoint for astronauts traveling to and from the lunar surface. in Earth orbit, the future is commercial. Private companies like Axiom Space are building their own stations, with the goal of having NASA and other customers pay to use their facilities, transitioning the post-ISS era from government-owned outposts to a commercialized space economy. Thanks for watching. Do you think the future of space stations should be government-run or fully commercial? Let me know in the comments down below. Please also remember to like and subscribe if you enjoyed.